everyone, welcome back to my channel, Accidental Beauty. And today I'm gonna get on a trend, hopefully before the trend is over, because I'm always late to like every trend. I'm either too early or too late. So I'm gonna try and get in on this trend before it kind of stops being a thing. There's this trend going around on YouTube where people try and recreate looks done by sort of more established influencers or YouTubers. So that's been going around a lot. I think it was started by Thomas Halbert. I think that's his name. I've heard it like so many times. I've watched all the videos and now I can't remember his name. I think that's his name. Anyways, I'll put a link to his channel below and I'll put, yeah. Today, I'm going to recreate Kathleen Light's video. She's like one of my favorite YouTubers. Put a link to her channel below. I don't have pretty much most of the products that she has, so I'm going to compensate with what I do have, which is what everyone in this challenge has been doing. So without further ado, let's get started. She is super talented. She uses the Jaclyn Hill palette, which I don't have, and I'm debating whether I should buy it or not, but I have dupes that I think I can recreate this look for also a fraction of the price. So I'm going to be using two BH Cosmetics eyeshadow palettes. So I've got the Foil Eyes 2 palette, there we go, and then Modern Matte's for transition shades. Okay, so she starts off with a Shape Tape concealer, which is one product that I actually have. What does she do? Okay, so my eyelids are primed. What next?
And now I'm gonna take the Jaclyn Hill palette and I'm gonna take this shade, and on a fluffy crease brush, I am just gonna buff this into my crease. I'm really putting this color on my entire crease. I'm not being precise with this or anything.
I'm gonna lightly go into this bad boy with a brush. I feel like I'm so aggressive when I'm blind, and like I don't even notice until I look at the footage. It's like, why are you so mad? I'm not. I'm just not dainty like some of these YouTubers who are like, hey. And I'm just like,
and then I'm gonna take this color right here. I know all of these.
So she's taking like a brownish red shade, which I don't have anything like that. Like, the closest thing is this one, but I feel like that's too like orangey red. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna take the same shade that I started with in the crease. Okay, this is a bit more orange than her shade, but it's okay. Okay, so she was actually more precise with that shade. So I'm gonna take my Anastasia brush that came with Modern Renaissance and just sort of pack that into the inner corner as well.
And then I'm gonna take this delicious blue and I'm gonna pack this.
Okay, we're going all out already. So she just used it as is. I might have to use some Fix Plus. I'm gonna use this dark blue from the Foil Eyes 2 palette, and then if it's not cobalt enough, I'm gonna add a bit of this purple. Okay, so I'm just gonna take some on the sort of flatter end of the Anastasia brush. Oops, and I got some on my nose, great. Shadows perform really nicely even without Fix Plus, but I like using it for that extra pop, but I'm gonna wait and see what she does. I'm going to add a bit of the purple on top.
this like reddish color looks against the blue. So I am packing this color into my crease. I'm actually putting a lot of this
color. Oh boy, now is the part where I could mess up.
Down, because I want to see the contrast of the blue and the red. So I'm applying a lot of it and then slowly diffusing it into my crease, kind of like dragging it up and making it a little bit more smoky and faded.
So she takes a dark reddish orangey color, which is sort of similar to this one, and she puts that in the crease, and she wants to basically create contrast with complementary colors. Okay, so I'm gonna use, got a new brush, really excited. It's the Morphe M507. What's a YouTube tutorial without mentioning Morphe brushes? Unfortunately, I don't have a code. I'm gonna take a bit of that on this brush. Whew. I'm just gonna add a bit more of the blue purple on the outside. Blend all that. That red-orange color blends out really, really nicely. So I'm gonna take a smidge more of that and just try and really get that where the two colors meet.
Then I'm gonna take this and go to the
red. So now she's using,
I'm gonna use this kind of like the sandwich color in between the blue.
She's
and
using
the
like a dark so red color. I don't have that, of course. So I think what I might do is just sort of mix a little bit of this dark purple and a little bit of this red-orange color that we used before. So now I'm just gonna take the dark purple, I think. Oh. I don't know if you can see that. My Morphe brush is already starting to shed.
I'm gonna go back into the blue and intensify it, of course, because when you apply a bunch of other eyeshadows on top, it will lose its intensity. So I'm just packing that color again, and same goes with this red shade.
Okay, you know what? I'm just gonna use a tiny bit of Fix Plus, just because I really want it to pop. So just put a little bit on my hand. Okay, that's looking really, really nice. Movie recording has stopped automatically. Thanks, camera. So I still feel like I always make the eyeshadow go too high, but I'm gonna just let it go for now.
Back into that crease color I used, I am just using this to diffuse any harsh lines right up in there.
Okay, she takes that peachy shade that we first used in the crease and then just sort of blends out or diffuses the edges.
And then I decided to go with this color versus the black because this one was a little more purpley. So I'm using this to deepen out the outer corners and make it, you know, sultrier.
So I think what I'm gonna do is mix a tiny bit of this black with this dark purple, and she just puts that in the outer V.
The palette doesn't really have a matte brow bone highlight, so I took the Balm Nude Beach palette and I dipped it into the shade Brilliant just to highlight my brow bone without a shimmery color. I took a brush with no additional product and I just blended out my crease.
I'm just gonna use my fingers. I'm just gonna take a little bit of this shade, the second one, and just blend that into the top part of my crease, and maybe it won't be terrible.
And now let's move on to the face. This is the Touch and Soul No Pore Blem Primer. And then I took the Hourglass Vanish Foundation Stick, and I'm mixing two shades because this one is a little bit too pale for me, but then this one is a little bit too dark for me, so I like mixing both of them. And then I'm just buffing it in.
Might have wet my sponge a bit too much, but I'm gonna put like a pump-ish of the foundation on the back of my hand.
And now for concealer, I'm just going to take my usual Tarte Shape Tape. This is in the shade Light Neutral, and I am just buffing that underneath my eyes.
I'm just going to fix up this eye a bit more.
To set that down, I took the new Kat Von D Blotting Powder in the shade Light, and I'm using that to set that, like I said.
Yeah, I don't know the difference between setting powder and finishing powder. Ugh, it's so powdery. But I like it, I use it, so if it works, it works, right?
To finish up the eyes, I just took this shade again, and I popped that in my inner corners.
Let's go back with, we're gonna go back into Foil Eyes 2, top left shade. Oh, that is pretty.
And then I just took the M Cosmetics new black eyeliner. It is amazing. It took me forever to take it off.
I'm going to use the Avon Glimmer Stick, which is kind of a misnomer, but it's a water... Oh, shit. It's a waterproof eyeliner. She tight lines her eyes, so she actually goes, like, on the waterline above the eye, and I've always been terrified of doing that, and then I think she goes on the lower lash line, too. Let's just see.
Which is a good thing.
Oh, this is actually gonna take me forever to get off. Okay. Oh, it's actually not so hard. Okay, my eyes are really annoyed with me. Just so excited to do this video.
But I took the first shade ever in the crease, and I'm using this to apply to my lower lash line.
Alright, now I'm gonna take a bit of that peachy shade. Okay, this look is starting to come together.
And I'm pretty much gonna just...
Oh, hers looks so nice, and mine is like...
And I'm pretty much gonna just use all the colors I used in my crease originally on my lower lash line.
And she uses all the shades we used up here, down here. I don't like doing that because I feel like I always mess it up. But for the sake of this video, who cares? I'm gonna do it. Hopefully that's it with the lower lash line because I'm like really done with this look.
With this darker color, I'm only going to focus this on the outer corners of my lower lash line just so that they can match my lid color as well, because I only have it on the outer corners.
Okay, no, that makes sense. Okay, I mean, this is looking cute. I never spend this long on makeup. Okay, come on, do the thing. Come on. I want to go eat dinner.
Oh, I also applied some more eyeliner to my waterline just to intensify it a bit.
Fine, I'll do a little bit more.
And then off camera, I applied some mascara and some falsies.
So, lashes and mascara are on. I obviously didn't have the same mascara as her, but it doesn't matter. And I don't have the same lashes as her. And these lashes might look like they don't match, but they do. I just sort of broke one, so we're gonna ignore that. But otherwise, they're super, super pretty. Highly recommend these.
And then that completes the eyes.
Of course, she does the rest of her face. So she contours, but she uses like more bronzers and contour. Thank you.
I'm using this to bronze my skin.
Okay.
It's one of my top five bronzers.
So I don't really have bronzer. This is the most bronze that I have. I don't want to overdo it, so I'm going to leave it as is.
And then I took the Charlotte Tilbury blush in the shade First Love. This is MAC Soft and Gentle, and I just applied this to the tops of my cheekbones and a little bit on my nose.
Okay, I'm liking this. Ooh, and there's like a piece of eyelash that's just like stabbing me in the inner corner of my eye.
And then for my lip color, I took the NARS Velvet Gloss Lip Pencil in the shade Buenos Aires.
So this is the final look. So this is the final look. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you liked it, please like or thumbs up or whatever on this video, comment, share it on social media, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. That would be super, super, super appreciated. And tell all your friends, and stay tuned for more videos to come. So thank you so much for watching.